come around a while, or if you haven't, we have a segment where we share the why. And today, Fayetta will be sharing why she believes in Proverbs 18 and 24. And I'll read that to you, and then I'll pass it over to Faye. It states, "One with many friends may be harmed, but there's a friend who stays closer than a brother."
It's funny that that scripture would be my scripture because if it's unchecked, you can drift back into that in your walk with God. And so you have to have those people that aren't afraid to bash through that barrier, bash through that wall, and break through and show you a different vantage point. Because if you're on the cliff and you're like, no, I'm good, no, I'm fine, no, I'm just gonna step right here, but you see somebody else like quarter over here, you clearly see I'm about to step off into danger. And so you're too much in it, you're too involved in it, you're too comfortable, you're too well, it's not that bad. You're too close to the situation to see exactly how harmful it is. You're too oblivious to the lion that's over there sitting and waiting for that treat that he got right in front of you, and you're trying to go get it, but he about to get you. You know, you need your friends that are around you, the people that, that aren't scared to look past that look on your face you have when you don't want nobody to talk to you. Or that emotion that you get when you feel like you're right but you're wrong. You know, my son is in a testament to that, because he'll say, no, Mom, you're wrong. And I'm like, but I'm your mama. I mean, I don't care if I'm wrong right now. You don't talk to me like that. And because he'll be like, but that's not right. And so you have to have that humility to be like, you know what, you're right. You're looking at it from an outside in, and I have to be able to accept that. And so I believe in Proverbs 18:24, because if it were not for the friends who were unafraid to speak light into the darkness that was my life, I wouldn't be here. I would not be alive. I can think of, like I said, Vivian, I can think of Tessa, I can think of Anitra, I can think of Yolanda. Yolanda and me. Yolanda and me have been through a lot of different ups and downs. Like I said, I was baptized in 97. Yolanda was baptized shortly thereafter. And it's funny, because our mothers knew each other. And we didn't realize that until months after we had been, she had been a disciple, we had been friends or whatever. And it's funny how your lives intertwine, how God does that. He kind of does the pre-work. And then you come in on the back end of it and reap the benefits of that. But we've hated each other as Christians. We've hated each other. We have fought tooth and nail, not physically, of course, as you know. We have not been on the same accord a lot of different times. But God has allowed us to grow from that. And it's in those fire times that closer than a brother thing grows. And it's funny how that happens, because you don't think that at the time. You don't know why it's such friction at the time. But Yolanda has been there for me more so than family. And I can't thank God enough for putting her in my life. Yeah. My child calls her grandmother. You know, that's how close they are. Her daughter calls me sister. You know, I've been there for different things. She's been there for me, and it's a deeper kind of relationship than family. And that's what I think that scripture talks about. If you can find one or two of those people, do not lose that. Don't run them away. Don't be so harsh to just bypass what God is trying to work in you, because it's through those people that you grow most. So I believe in that scripture, because I have life because of it. Yeah.